Welcome to this week's segment of Dialogue Houston. I'm your host, Lawrence Payne. To our regular viewing audience, welcome. To those joining us perhaps for the first time here for ACC's TV Dialogue Houston, we're here now every Tuesday and Thursday at 6 a.m. and again at 6 p.m. and Saturday afternoons at 3 p.m. As always, in top of the hour, let me thank you for your calls, emails, and text messages concerning previous shows we've aired here on ACC TV, but particularly your great ideas for guest topics and subjects to be covered on upcoming segments of Dialogue Houston. For after all, this is your community affairs, public affairs show here on ACC TV, now proudly in its 26th season. We have a great show planned for you today. We're going to look at a wonderful aspect of life here in Houston at a partner sister educational institution that works with ACC, and that is the University of St. Thomas, which is in the heart of Montrose, as we say, and even the name UST is in the heart of Houston, the name UST in the heart of Houston. And representing the university today are two fine young men and gentlemen who are also members of the basketball team, Go Celtics. And in full disclosure, because you already know what I'm going to say, because I've said this before on the show, yes, I'm a graduate of the University of St. Thomas and an alumni. I have two young men here who are student athletes. They're on the basketball team. I always say I have the distinction of being on the original first basketball team at the University of St. Thomas. But these young men as student athletes have taken this new era of what it means to be a person of faith and character on the campus of St. Thomas to a whole new level. I'm proud to have joining me Leonard Robinson and his twin brother, Kennard Robinson. Welcome to both of you. Great to have you here, guys.
Thanks for having us.
This is one of those opportunities you get very now and then. First of all, that both of you are together at St. Thomas, I think that's phenomenal. And both of you are on the basketball team. But tell me, both of you, what brought you to UST?
Well, for me, what brought me to UST is Coach Medina, Anthony Medina. He recruited me when I was going through the recruiting process. He just showed me how much he cared for me on and off the court, and he showed me and brought me to University of St. Thomas on my visit what all University of St. Thomas has to offer that I didn't know about, and where is it located in the heart of the city downtown. And I just like the campus and the community of the people around me, and really Coach Medina, because we have like such a great bond. Mm-hmm. And then I get to stay home close to my family and play with my brother at the same school in college like we wanted to do all our lives.
I love it. Kennard, what brought you?
To elaborate on what my brother said, the way that Coach Medina pursued us in the recruiting process, he was just relentless, you know, and any coach that's that relentless like that and really wants you on that campus,
right,
you know, he's a good man,
right,
and he really cares on and off the court no matter what. And I do appreciate everything Coach Medina done and continue to do for us. He wants nothing but the best for us, you know, and once he brought me to the campus on our visit, it was just had me stuck right away, mm-hmm, because I met some beautiful people, amazing people, you know, that cared about my future right away and wanted to help regardless. And I finally get to play alongside my brother at home, so
all right,
why not?
All right. Which high school did y'all go to?
Oh, we went to Sam Houston Math Science Technology Center.
Okay, all right. You were talking in the green room before we started taping and filming here. St. Thomas, because the size of the campus, because of the size of the student body, gives you this really personal, warm feeling where it's really a family, extended family. Everybody pretty much gets to know everybody on the campus, even by name. I mean, amazing how many people know each other by name on the campus. What's been your experience with that feeling?
My experience with that feeling is just, Coach Medina, he actually helped me and he pushed me to do this. Like every year, I need to go out and meet at least 20 new people, introduce myself to anybody so I can, you never know, I might meet some great people that I come across, which everybody I met at University of St. Thomas were great people, but they also could help me with different aspects in my life. So I met all type of different people I didn't think I would meet. Like I have friends now from different countries like France and from all over the world, mm-hmm, that I never did think I would meet. And there's some great people that can help me in the classroom that I didn't know about But once I went around introducing myself and telling them and just speaking up, using my voice and asking for help, I used the tools that University of St. Thomas gave me and offered me. And it's been a fun experience.
And it's all, Kennard, it's all about connections and network anyway. The more you network, the more your connections, the more you meet people who may be able to help you down the road in ways that you don't even know about. You get to meet some of the parents of the students who are already connected. So, you know, I'm sure you had similar experience as your brother in just meeting new people on the campus, right?
Yes, sir. With me, it's just I try to interact with anybody I could, you know, because I'm one of the persons that's, like, I'm always happy, you know, laughing, just want to put a smile on someone's face. So if I can meet someone new any day, I would. I just go up to them, speak to them, you know. Because it takes little out of your day just to see how people's days are going, you know. Yeah. It means a lot to them.
It does.
Because some people don't get that all the time. So I just try to ask people how their day going and how are they, you know, meet new people and network like that. So I participate in everything I could because besides basketball, I'm always busy.
Mm-hmm.
But if I have a little free time, I can go play flag football with other people, you know.
Right.
Go study, play ping pong and stuff like that. So it's always good to interact.
And I know y'all, because of the coach and the team, I know y'all also were involved in some community service projects. Tell us about that, because I think that's very important that y'all did that and some great things that y'all were involved with.
We did some community projects where we did the food bank.
Mm-hmm.
We went
Houston
there.
Food bank, yeah.
We prepared like different meals and put like care packages together for the homeless or people in need. And we also went to one of the Catholic churches and we helped them prepare newspapers and like the Catholic newspapers that they create. We helped them do that for the kids and get all gift wraps like around Christmas time and help them with things like that in that nature.
And we recently just did something with like, you know, foster kids with basketball. You know, it was amazing to be there with the kids and interact and introduce myself and play, you know, and teach them basketball because, you know, they foster kids. So they, you know, they've been through a lot, you know, it just make them smile and have fun. Like, that's all I can do. I gave back to what I could, you know, so I just love to see people happy.
Since you both majored in different disciplines, so that means you were involved with different departments of the university. Talk to me a little bit about that, because I think because you were in different disciplines and different parts of the campus and different professors, you had a chance to really see a lot of different things based upon you and communications and business. So tell us how did that go?
Well, it's going well. I'm actually in my senior year.
Yep.
I'm a communication major, so I'm in my senior year, and like I met a whole lot of different people. I learned how to voice my use my voice, and how different ways I should talk, and how to properly talk when I'm around people.
Mm-hmm.
And I learned how to network better. And it's just, I learned proper skills that I need to use in my everyday life, not just in school, but I can use them when I'm around, away from school, and just around other people that I never met before and how to interact with them.
And in business, you know, I learned so many new things, how to dress, you know, about business aspects with money, sales, and anything like that. Everything I needed to know about business and managing a business, I learned. And I'm continuing to learn as my senior year, I'm finishing up.
So we graduate in May?
I graduate in December.
Oh, December?
Yes, sir.
December
this
of
December.
2020?
Yes, sir.
I will be graduating in December as well.
Okay, so graduation's in December, end of the year. We have a great celebration and graduation. So what's next?
What's next for me? I'm planning on playing professional basketball after my college career is over with. I'm unsure where I want to go, to the NBA or overseas, but whichever opportunity is best for me, that's the route I'm going to take, and that's what I plan to do afterwards.
I also plan to play professionally in Italy.
Okay.
I really love Italy.
All right.
You know, that's where I want to go. But other than that, I always have a backup plan, no matter what.
There you go.
And wherever God takes me, that's where I'm going.
So I understand that the scouts are sniffing around.
Yes, sir.
The NBA scouts and some other scouts. That's always a good thing. Because it's really kind of wide open right now, right?
Yes, sir.
I'm sure they've followed you since your high school career, some of them. You've now had a great college career. The Celtics doing good. And it's important to think about that next phase of life, as you say, whatever it's going to be, with some flexibility.
Yes, sir.
But I think that what happens coming out of a university like St. Thomas, it really gives you that grounded perspective on life, on your future, on your career, on kind of the things that you've been exposed to in a broader sense of things. Like you mentioned, the international flavor of the student body, you got to meet folk from all over the globe. But that helps round you out in a much deeper way than if you would have gotten perhaps in other institutions. Speak to that for a moment before we take a break. We only got a few seconds, but just speak to that for a little while before we take a break.
Well, I feel that the well-rounded aspect of the school that I have, it sets me up perfectly for me thinking ahead, like what I would not have thought mm-hmm. if I was at another university. Like now I'm in my senior year, I'm already thinking about the things that I plan on doing after college.
Right.
Like, if not basketball, what do I plan to do if I didn't have basketball?
Mm-hmm.
Which I know what I want to do. I feel like if I was at any other university, I would not have been thinking the way I'm thinking and thinking logically about what do I want to do after my career is done.
I like that.
So,
yeah. University of St. Thomas is just put you in situations in the classroom and prepares you for the future. That's all I really can say because you never know what the future holds.
Right.
But St. Thomas is prepared.
There's life after basketball also.
Right, sir.
And the other thing.
And St. Thomas prepares you for those situations.
So I got to ask you, Kenna, why Italy?
It's a beautiful country. I don't know.
I mean, I agree with you. I mean, one of my favorite places in the world is Florence. I could live there tomorrow, move there tomorrow, and stay.
I mean, and it's close to, you know, like Paris.
Okay.
You know, that's a love city.
So you're ready to see the rest of the world.
Yeah, I love traveling.
Okay, there it is right there. That's the answer right there. All right, we're going to take a small pause and break. When we come back, we're going to dive a little deeper with the guys as to what has been one of the aspects at being at the University of St. Thomas, a Catholic university, that upholds certain values and very strongly, and is woven in through all the classes they take in different ways. And I want to just kind of visit with them a little bit to speak to what some of those things that they saw and understand very clearly out of that discipline, out of that environment. Please stay tuned and we'll be right back.
This is Mac. She's ready to build herself a house and a business. But first, she's building her resume with a construction certification from Houston Community College. HCC, for everyone, anytime.
Reader. She'd carry two novels on an airplane because she'd read one on a 3-4 hour ride. And at some point, I began to notice that she would read a page and couldn't remember what she had just read, and she'd have to go back and read it again.
I don't remember much these days after I read, but less does for me, and I love it.
I don't know an industry today that doesn't rely on some amount of coding to run their business. Coding is the 21st century equivalent of the English language. And our particular flavor of this is the iOS Coding and Design School. And Apple's been very supportive and in fact joined with us to roll out the start of this Swift programming initiative So it's a great opportunity to combine creativity with science and technology, contributing to this app economy.
Meet Wally. He's a single dad. He's also a role model for his 5-year-old son, going back to school with him. This time, Wally's going to Houston Community College for a second career. HCC, for everyone, anytime.
Welcome back to this week's segment of Alloc Houston. If you're with me for the first part of the show before the break, you know we are talking about and with students, athletes who are in their senior year from the University of St. Thomas, from the Celts, our basketball team, who's, by the way, having a winning season. We're going to talk about that in a minute, too. And joining me are Leonard Robinson and Kennard Robinson. And yes, before your eyes play trick on you, they are twins. And we've been talking about the aspects of being on the University of St. Thomas campus. We've been talking about why it's so important to be in that wonderful institution that is small yet large enough to meet all your needs and requirements, but yet small enough that you become family. Many times by name, everybody kind of knows each other, and many people know each other's name, and how important that has been to their maturation process as they move toward graduation. I want to talk to them now as we go forward. Dr. Richard Ludwig, our wonderful president, has initiated with the Board of Directors of St. Thomas this thing we call the Call Toward Tomorrow. This is a visioning process about how and where we see the University of St. Thomas positioned in the city going forward. One of the slogans that have come out of that is one that I think is really appropriate for the times and really allows people to develop it and flesh it out in their own way. And the slogan is to be your bold self. So guys, individually, what does that slogan mean to you, to be your bold self?
It actually means to me, be who you are truly. You know, don't worry about what nobody else thinks of you. Just be your bold self. And honestly, on the campus of University of St. Thomas, it's so many different people with different aspirations, different goals, and different beliefs. And you should never worry about what other people are thinking. Just be you, and other people are gonna like you and love you for who you truly are. You never know, so be your bold self speaks volumes to me, to my brothers, to everyone around campus. Be who you truly are.
All right.
And to me, it also means be your bold self means don't be scared to chase after your dream. Go after what you believe in and push to the extreme. Don't be scared to work hard and do the work that nobody else is doing. You know, be your bold self. Just go after what you want. If you really want it, go do it. If you believe in it, you gotta believe in it, you have to do it to achieve it. So that's how I take it, and that's what I believe be your bold self is.
I was telling Dr. Ludwig, I said on my time on that campus, late 60s, early 70s, if I'd have been my bold self, I'd have get kicked out of school, probably. But it was that era. It was a civil rights movement. It was in the whole era of change and development. I was, I guess, somewhat of a radical. I had a fro out to here and really, but it was a challenging times. The University of St. Thomas gave me that groundedness that I needed. It gave me a sense of family, as you said, a sense of community. There were people that had my back. Sometimes I knew who they were and that they had my back. Sometimes there were people who had my back that didn't even know they had my back. And so that was important. But what it also did, because it's a Catholic institution, it grounded me in something called the Catholic social teaching and in social justice. And that weave, that thread that is woven and weaved throughout the university, throughout every course that you take, every class that you take, it's embedded in how the issues are talked about and are discussed. Tell me a little bit about that sense of those pieces of the puzzle about the social justice aspect that you've picked up in your classes as you've gone forward.
Well, what I picked up, well, the school is Catholic, and we're not Catholic, we're Baptist. But
that really doesn't matter.
That really doesn't matter, right? Because it's teaching the same thing to me, because it has faith and reason. Mm-hmm. And that was those two pillars that our school goes by with the Catholic University and the aspects we have. We have faith and reason. So with faith and reason, you can take that throughout your everyday life, even in the classroom. And you have to have faith with your reason and what you want to do with some things. So I feel like the school taught us that, and it's something I can take and use in my everyday life, not just on the court, not just in the classroom, but with anything. When I'm making a decision, or just if I'm feeling down or feeling low, like my feelings towards everything.
Faith is everything. Without faith, what are you believing in? You know, and you gotta have a reason behind everything you do. My coach always told me, don't do nothing without meaning. Whatever you do, you gotta have a meaning behind it. Mm-hmm. Because every impact you do can have an impact on somebody else. I didn't know that until, you know, me growing up.
Good point, yeah.
Me growing up, I didn't know a lot of kids looked up to me like that. And me seeing kids coming out of games, it's just heartwarming, you know. And they look up to me and wanna be like me. So I have to have a reason behind everything I do and I keep my perspective.
And right. Do it with purpose and passion.
Yes, sir.
It really is about purpose and passion. Speaking of the games and the team, we have a winning season.
Yes, sir.
A lot of that has to do with you two guys sitting here. So tell us about this winning season of UST's.
Well, we're 17-1.
17-1. I just want to put that out there directly into the 17-1. Thank you.
We're the number one team in the conference.
Okay.
And we're the number two team in the nation in NCAA D3 basketball.
Y'all got that? Number one team, number two team in the nation. And we're part of which league now?
NCAA D3, Division III basketball.
Okay. And so the games that are left, and then the playoffs.
Yes, sir.
Want everybody who has not attended a University of St. Thomas basketball game, still got time. Come join us, come view it, you'll really appreciate it. But let me turn for a moment, because I think it's important to say a few words, because it is about faith and character, and obviously he was one of those individuals. Kobe Bryant, the untimely passing of Kobe last Sunday and his daughter. And if you listen to all the testimonials this week thus far, that he was an incredible basketball player, yes, but he was an incredible man and father. And at 41 years old, he just was coming into his stride. His foundation that he set up was doing great things all across the country and the globe, and was positioned to do a lot more. One of the things that I realized in listening to all this about him this week, since he was drafted right out of high school, he started his career early and young. Ball players burn out by the time they're 29, 30. You're an old man in the league. So he was young, had a young career, and he still was young. What has, in your thoughts and reflections in his passing, what are your thoughts about Kobe?
Kobe Bryant, you know, he was a living legend. He left a legacy behind. He changed the game for all of us. He showed me what hard work really is, and the amount of work you put in, what it can do for you. And Kobe Bryant was an amazing basketball player, but he was an amazing person. I didn't know him personally, but just me watching Kobe and the passion and drive, he gave everything he could to the game. And me watching him on TV, watching him in person when he would come play the Rockets, like, it's amazing to watch that man, because it's too easy for him. But nobody sees the work he put in behind closed doors.
That's a good point. And he made it look easy, but it was a lot of work and time.
A lot of work, time and effort and dedication. He went through injuries, and he played through injuries. And that just shows, like, you can push through anything no matter what. And Kobe, he changed everything for me, you know, because a lot of people didn't like Kobe. But that didn't even matter, because Kobe is going to be Kobe, you know, at the end of the day. And his passing really, you know, touched a lot of people in the world. And very devastating and tragic, you know, because he left a legacy behind, and he changed the game for all of us, and I thank him.
Lenore?
And for me, Kobe, he was a great family man. He was a great man overall, and I feel like he affected not just me, but everybody around the world that watched him and knew of him and watched him grow up and playing basketball, from just a young kid out of high school, going into the league, being a five-time NBA winning championships, and being a superstar that he is. Like, he is just a great man, like, and the passing of him, I know it's just tragic. It's like one of those that really hits home for not just me and basketball players, but other people that doesn't even play basketball, but just saw this man on TV playing basketball.
Right.
And the things that he was doing after he finished basketball, he was setting up, he had an academy, and he wanted to give back with
Mamba.
His daughter, Mamba Academy.
Yeah.
He wanted to give back to the game that he loved.
Right.
So he started a foundation, which he was setting up for him, his family, and his daughter, and other kids that he wanted to grow up and play basketball just like he did.
One of the things I learned this week is that he was the first player in the NBA to get the referee's book about how the referees are trained, and particularly how they see calls and fouls, even where they stand on the court. He learned where they stand on the court so he could always be in a different angle so they could see his shots and see his fouls. He's the first player that did that.
Mm-hmm.
Now, others have done that because he did it.
Yes,
but he took the time to learn his craft, to learn his game, and to learn every aspect about it, which was phenomenal. And so it really has made a difference, they said, in the way he played, because he was conscious of the whole court. He knew where everybody was, and everything on that court was at all times, which I think is interesting. All right, we got a little time left, very short. So when's our next game?
Friday at 5:30.
This Friday at 5:30, and who we play? Who we going to slay? I mean, who we going to take out? I mean, who we going to beat?
We play Trinity.
We play Trinity. Ah, okay. So this Friday, 5 p.m., it's Friday at 5 p.m. It's after work. What else you got to do? Come to the University of St. Thomas to the gym, the Jarabig Gym, in the middle of the campus. Just ask anybody. They'll point you to the gym. 5 o'clock, University of St. Thomas, 17-1 Celts play Trinity. And after that game, you can follow us to the next game and follow us to the playoffs. And really become a fan of St. Thomas. To know us is to love us, we've always said. It's a wonderful campus in the heart of Houston, in the heart of Montrose. The UST is even the name of Houston, in the middle of Houston is UST. These two wonderful men, Leonard and Kennard Robinson, represent the best of the best of what it means to be a student athlete who really understands the head, the heart, and the gut. Who really understands that it's the development of the cognitive, affective, and behavioral parts of our being, that it's also about giving back, it's about community service, it's about be your bold self, it's about the two pillars are?
Faith and reason.
It's about faith and reason. It has always been about faith and reason. Beyond that, there's not much else to talk about. So come see us, come join us. If you haven't ever visited the campus, this gives you an opportunity. Gentlemen, thank you very much. I look forward to following your career after you graduate. I look forward to hearing about the great things you both are going to accomplish, because I know you will. And it's just a pleasure to have you be with us on the set.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you very much. We're going to get out of here. Until next time, as always, we look forward to you joining us on future segments of Dialogue Houston. And until then, peace, power, and love.